Hello, everyone. Welcome to our Thursday evening social. I keep trying to remember it's Thursday evening. I don't know. I feel like my days keep getting mixed up. Last week, you know, we had the short week, and I'm here in Colorado, in Denver, and we had a snow day last week. So I'm still kind of like, what day is this? It's Thursday. So we're going to get ready. We're going to work in our journal tonight. We're going to work on our gratitude log on page 13. And if you've already done it, no worries. We're going to kind of talk about it, talk about some different ideas about it. You can always do different things. And then we're going to do our day in the life letter, which is on page 15. So again, I always like to tell folks, if for any reason, as we're doing one of these activities, if it's not really speaking to you, if you're kind of not feeling inspired or you're not really sure what to write, hang out in the chat, listen to the music. Sometimes something will pop into your head later, so it's absolutely fine. It's, we're just happy that you're here and you're spending some time, right? This is a great way to spend some time with yourself, a little self-care. So fabulous. So my name is Maya, and I will be the facilitator. And with me tonight is Jennifer O, and she's down in Texas. She's going to pop on and give you a little wave, and she'll be monitoring the chat. So in case you have any questions, any technical difficulties, anything like that, you can just kind of pop in the chat and let her know. And I'll be kind of keeping an eye on it as well. But sometimes, as you know, sometimes the chat goes by really fast. So Jennifer will be in there checking as well. So make sure that you have set your chat to everyone so that everyone can see what you're saying. And I know sometimes if you're on the phone, it will keep popping back to the host and panelist. So you have to keep changing that. Also, if you're on the phone, I think sometimes when we're working and we have the music going and you have the chat going, sometimes it will only let you do the chat, and then you can't hear the music, and then you kind of pop back and forth. So sometimes it gets a little wonky, and sometimes it gets a little, I cut in and out a little bit sometimes from the phone. So also sometimes, as Jennifer's saying, sometimes logging off and coming back will help reset if there's any sort of audio problems. Also, you know, make sure your earphones, if they're plugged in, you've got your volume up, you don't have the sound muted, all those kinds of things. All right. So let's get started. Let's dive right in. So as you know, we only have a few days left of January, believe it or not. But this month's theme is abundance. And I think that's such a fabulous, it's been such a fun theme. It's been fun to see people kind of talking about this idea of abundance and really thinking about how a mindset of abundance is different from that mindset of scarcity, right? Really kind of approaching things with the idea of abundance. Things are, you have everything you need. There's, things are there in abundance, right? And so hopefully you've been kind of digging into that, kind of thinking about what that means, how that kind of works in your life. And so our agenda for tonight, we are going to do a little, I like to call it a warm-up activity, right? Kind of get you thinking about this idea of abundance. And then we're going to work on our gratitude log, which is in page 13. And then we're going to work on the day in the life on page 15. So, and Jennifer's telling me I saw her say something about we're very international. We have someone from Ireland, which I'm guessing it's probably either very late in the early or late in the evening or early in the morning that they're joining us. So that's fabulous. We love to have our Sonder fam from far and wide come and join. That's the great thing about this community. We have an abundance of voices, an abundance of experiences, and it's always fabulous to have everyone here with us together. So you might think that a cornucopia is only for Thanksgiving, but no. I would say no. Today we are going to look at this as our abundance cornucopia, right? And the idea with a cornucopia is that there's just an abundance of everything in there, overflowing, right? This idea of It really is a good symbol of abundance and bounty. So what you're going to do is you're going to draw a cornucopia, and I'm going to show you a little tutorial that Jennifer had made, a little kind of step-by-step drawing. And you're going to draw that. And then in your cornucopia, you're going to either draw some images, maybe some symbols, words, pictures, put stickers in there of things that you want to welcome more of in your life, things that you want more of in your life. It can be this month, it can be this year, it can be this week, just as you're kind of thinking, what do you want to bring more of into your life? So here's a fun little tutorial, right? So you start out with kind of that oval, and this is, you can find a blank page in your January journal. You can use scratch paper. If you want to make a small cornucopia, you could always use that scratch pad section in there. Any space will do. It doesn't have to take up a full page. So you've got your oval there, right, in that top left, and then you're going to kind of draw this little horn around, and you could always do it left-handed too, right, whichever way that you would like. Then within that oval, you're going to kind of draw another little oval here in the bottom, right? And then as you can see, then in the next one, you're going to erase that little, there's that where that little line is. So you will end up with something that looks kind of like this bottom right hand cornucopia, right? And again, you can use, if you want to do the cornucopia, you want to do this drawing, it's perfect. Yeah, Brenda's saying it's a backward C that's kind of on there. Perfect. If you're like, you know what, I can't draw this cornucopia, it's stressing me out, don't worry about it. You can just make a list. You could draw a glass. You could draw a cup. You could draw just a chart, right? You can just kind of write on there. So it does not have to be the actual cornucopia, but it is fun to try. You can also, if you're doing this, you know, if you have an online version, you could always find an online picture that you can kind of, if you have one of those little printers, you could print out and put in there. So hopefully everybody sees how to draw this little cornucopia. Everybody feeling okay? I can always go back once we kind of get started if you're not quite sure how to do the cornucopia. Yeah, Georgette's saying she did this in another social. So it's a super fun idea to just kind of see with this idea of abundance, right? So some of the things that you can think of as you're thinking of, what do I want to put into my cornucopia? What are the things that I want more of in my life? And if you're thinking like, gosh, I'm kind of drawing a blank. So here's some things to think about. What makes you happy, right? What are your needs? What are some things that maybe you need? What are your personal values? This is a great opportunity if you've done the values class with Meha, the online class that you can take for personal values. Great time to kind of think about your values and think about maybe what you need that will help you bring those values more to light and more prominent in your life. What gives you purpose? Maybe there's some things you can think of that would help give you purpose. What activities put you in a flow state? So hopefully, you know, you've heard of that term, the flow state, where you're doing something and you lose track of time. You kind of lose track of what's going on. You forget to eat. You forget to get up and go to the bathroom. You forget to stretch. You're just like really in the moment. So what kinds of things really get you in that flow state? What would you do if there were no limits? Right. Again, you don't necessarily have to think of it's not a I have to think of what I can only what I can do. Right. No limits. Who do you admire or get jealous of? How do you envision the patterns in your life? What don't you want? Maybe you want to put something in there and put a big X over it. Or think about also maybe what are your greatest accomplishments in life? What do you want to accomplish more of? And I see someone was in there posting, I need more beach time. Yes, absolutely. Steph, I hear you. More time at the beach, right? It's a little difficult here in Colorado, but, sometimes we get away to the beach. So this is mine. I just kind of did a quick, I did it online just so that I could get that done quickly. But I put things like relaxation, self-acceptance, knitting, health and wellness, time with friends, community, travel, nature, change. And then I found some fun little pictures to put in there as well. And I really like the sign up at the top that says old ways won't open new doors. And so that kind of goes along with the idea of change. I think a lot of times we fear change, but sometimes that's what we need. Maybe we need things to change. And you notice I do have a beach picture down there on the bottom with relax. So always got that beach idea, that beach theme there. So take some time. I'll flip back and forth through the slides. I'll go back to this one again in case you need to draw it. Well, I'll start with this one and then we'll go into the other ones. I'm going to play some music. Let us know in the chat what kinds of things you're putting there. I see Brenda says she wants to draw some clouds. Awesome. So just kind of let us know what are some things that you want to see. All right. And I'll be checking in with you in the chat. All right. So many great ideas, things that people are putting in the chat. I loved that someone, they'd drawn a cornucopia, so they were feeling like they wanted to draw something different. So they did a picnic basket. So I love that idea, like a nice big basket or a picnic basket or just some sort of a amazing container that's just overflowing with this abundance of things that you want more of in your life, right? And I think it's important for us sometimes when we think about these things, not so much necessarily to say you want to spend more time doing it, but just saying you want to spend more, you want more of this in your life, right? And so these are great things. Look back at this when you do your next weekly setup. And when you're thinking of those habits, right? We have those places where you have to put, well, you don't have to put, where you can come up with some different habits that you want to have for the week. Look at this list, right? What are some things you can do now? If I want travel to be, you know, something that I want more of in my life, maybe I have a weekly habit of checking airfare, right? Or looking for sales or kind of figuring out when I can take vacation. That's going to be maybe one of my habits that I'm going to do a couple times that week. Or if I'm thinking, you know, if I want more self-acceptance, then maybe what I want to do is add on there to the habits that I want to, writes loving affirmations on my mirror, right? With one of those, with the dry erase marker, right? So use this to think of ways that you can incorporate this into your life so that you can have more of these things in your life. All right. So hopefully everybody's got a nice list, got a lot of things that you're kind of thinking about, folks saying they want more time to dream, more time to savor the small stuff. A lot of you talked about spending more time outdoors. I will say it's been pretty cold here in Denver, so I'm not real keen on spending more time outdoors right now. But eventually, when it warms up, I definitely want to get back outside. Things like hugs and cuddles, more time with grandbabies, more time with family, more time with more smiles in your life, more joy, more self-care, more. I know a lot of you like the music, and I will share my playlist here at the end. More instrumental, calming music, more time with yourself. Maybe it's more, maybe it's coming to more socials. Could always be that as well, right? All right. So let's move on. Let's dig into our journals now. And let's dig into that gratitude log on page 13. And again, I know it's kind of late in the month. And so maybe some of you have already filled in some of these. Absolutely fine. If you're like me, I start out kind of gung-ho and get, you know, a few of these. I like to do it sometimes each day, right? So, because you can see there's 1 through 31. So you, part of the idea is you could say I'm grateful for, so it's something you could fill out at the end of each day. I do pretty good for the first few days and then it tends to drop off. It's okay. It doesn't matter, right? You can always fill things in now. You can always be grateful and you can always spend some time thinking about what you're grateful for. So let's take a look at some examples of things that people have done. So remember, we love for you to share in Sonder Club pictures from your journal if you feel comfortable, right? So, These are from other Sonder fam members like you, right? These are when people share in Sonder Club, we take snapshots and we pop these in so folks can see them. So you can see very lovely writing over on the left-hand job, all one color, lovely writing, kind of saying things like, you know, being grateful for opportunities and maybe discovering different things. The one in the middle is super amazing. And I love Jennifer and I were talking about how beautiful this is with the lettering, how it fills up that whole, I don't know if you want to think of it as like a sunshine ray or whatever, but it kind of fills that whole thing up and there's big letters, small letters, but it just kind of fills that up. And I love that in different colors. So it's very, very vibrant and beautiful and a great thing to look back on when you're thinking of what you're grateful for. And then the one over on the right, again, they use just some different colored markers, just some different ideas for things, you know, and these don't have to be huge things. These can be small things. Maybe I'm always grateful when my husband gets me a Sonic iced tea when he is driving by a Sonic and gets me an iced tea. I love iced tea. even in the winter. I know it's kind of crazy because it's a little cold right now. You know, things like clean sheets, grateful for clean sheets. I'm grateful for a sunny day, right? Any of those things. And it's always, it's so good to give yourself some time to think about the things you're grateful for. Yes, Jennifer is saying coffee. Absolutely grateful for coffee. 100%. I'm grateful for my warm, fuzzy slippers because it's chilly, right? Grateful for phone calls with my mom every morning. I like to call her, make sure she's taken her medicine for the day. And then we chat for probably way too long as I sit in my car outside of work, right? So just think of some things that you're grateful for. I think that was, oh, and here's another page actually. See, there's so many fun examples. And if you do this, when you do it on an everyday basis, and maybe you miss a day and you don't want to necessarily fill that day in, you can see the one on the bottom left, they just have colored it in with pretty, looks like it's pretty sun rays. So if there's, you don't have to fill up every line, right? You can put, oh, Brenda, it's yours. Yay. I love the color there, right? Just kind of fun. You can just kind of do whatever, right? Again, this is a beautiful way to share your gratitude. We often include some sort of a gratitude log in almost every journal because it's something that is so helpful for people as they're kind of thinking about starting their day or at the end of their day. So again, I'm going to play some music, let you work on yours. If you want to color yours, if you want to maybe work on your coloring page, if you've already done your gratitude log, but feel free to keep sharing in the chat kind of how you use this and what you do. And then we'll pop back in. Right. So a lot of great conversation in the chat about some different ideas, different ways that you can kind of go about this idea of filling out your gratitude log. And it definitely is something I think that's really important. And I know sometimes it sounds a little hokey to come up with, you know, things that you're grateful for, but it really is rooted in science. And there's been a lot of research around how I don't know, fortunately or unfortunately, humans are kind of geared more toward a negative bias, and we're geared to remember the bad things. We're geared to remember things that aren't so good, probably evolutionary, because our human, you know, years ago, we had to remember things that were bad so we wouldn't do them again because they could potentially be dangerous. But it makes things tough because we do tend to perseverate, right, on some really bad things that happen, and we forget the good things, right? Do you ever come home from work and you're like, oh, traffic was horrible and this happened and this person said this and right? And you just kind of start listing out all these bad things. I would challenge you to go to your gratitude log, right? One you filled out or one that's blank or blank piece of paper or whatever, and just list one thing you're grateful for. Right? Just try and think of something you're grateful for that day. And my guess is once you can think of one thing, maybe you can think of another, and maybe you can think of another. And we really do have to work at that. And I know that's kind of frustrating too. It's like, why do we have to be so geared to the negative? Well, it's just how we are. So it's just a given. So we know that we're going to have to do a little extra work to think about what we're grateful for, right? So yeah, Nona Natalie saying she also frames it as sometimes what helped inspire me to pull through today. And again, it could be something like a good cup of coffee, or maybe somebody, you know, paid for your drink in line ahead of you, or somebody's ice cream. Yep, grateful for, always grateful for ice cream, right? So as we start to kind of think of these things, and again, I know sometimes it seems cheesy, but you just start listing out the things you're grateful for, and it really does physiologically in your body change how things are working. So spend some time doing that. Again, like I said, we almost always every month try to have something in there that's kind of, it's either maybe a gratitude log or a gratitude jar where you can kind of fill it up with things, but it's always a fun thing to do. And it's really fun to look back on. Take a picture of it when it's finished. Make it your screensaver on your phone, right? Something that you, every time you look at, makes you remember the things that you're grateful for. Very, very important. And we, of course, are always very grateful for our Sonder fam to be here, to come to these socials and join in and spend some time with some time for yourself, right? All right. So let's, and I forgot to tell you, I had put, I did put this up. There's a gratitude log ideas for different topics. I know someone had said that sometimes they get stagnant in kind of always thinking of the same topic area or area of their life where there's gratitude. So here's these different ideas for things that you might want to think about. And I forgot to say too, at the beginning, for folks who are new, it's always a good idea to do some screenshots. Sometimes you can, if you have your phone with you, or if you're on the computer, can do screenshots. Those will be there. We'll also give you at the end of the webinar, we'll give you a link for a recording. So you can always go back and look. The chat's not there. Sometimes the music is redacted, but the slides will be there for you to see. So if you ever need to kind of go back and go over those. All right. So let's hop on to one that I know sometimes folks find a little bit challenging. When you have to write yourself a letter, we like to do those in the journals too, but I know sometimes people save those for a social because it really kind of gives them that dedicated time. So this is on page 15. Yeah. Jennifer's saying these blank pages always stop me in my track, right? You get this big blank with here's a prompt and here's a bunch of lines and it's like, oh. So I love to do them with Sonder fam as well, like have that nice dedicated time to work on these. So this is what the top of that page says. So imagine yourself exactly 1 year from now, living your abundant life. Who are you with? Where are you located? What are you doing? Don't think about how you're going to get there. Don't think about what you have to do in order to get there. Don't think about challenges or roadblocks or any of those kinds of things. Just vision it, right? And it can either be, so it says exactly 1 year from today, but if you want to think of a different time, maybe you want to think of a day further down the road. Maybe you want to think of 5 years from now. Maybe you want to think of 10 years, 15 years. anything that works for you, just kind of think of it that way. Also, for some folks, and I know I've seen some in the chat where some folks are maybe at a challenging time in their life, right? Things are kind of changing. Things are going to be different for them, maybe going through a divorce, death of a loved one, loss of a job, those kinds of things. So maybe trying to think of a year from now is too much. It's too, too intense. So you want to kind of pull it in. Maybe you want to envision yourself 1 month from now. Right. So maybe at the end of February, what this looks like. Yeah. Patty says 8 years retirement. I hear you, Patty. right. So think of what time frame you want to use, be it a year, be it a month. It could even be, you know, like 2 days from now, a week from now, whatever works for you to write this letter. You can also, the other thing I thought of, sometimes I like to think of different seasons, because what I'm doing and what my day in the life looks like is really different based on the season. So maybe you want to divide this up into four sections, and you pick a year from now in the winter, a year from now in the spring, a year from now in the summer, a year from now in the fall, right? And kind of think about, because again, you know, who are you with? Where are you located? What are you doing? How you're feeling could look different depending upon the seasons. Another good thing to do here is to go back. Does anybody ever do this? You spend a lot of time on your monthly intentions, right? That was at the beginning of the month. That's on page, let me flip to that. That's on page 9, right? You spend all this time with your monthly intentions, and then you never look back at it again for the rest of the month. So this is a good opportunity. Go back and see what were those intentions for the month of January, or you can think of it, you know, for the year. And if you embrace those intentions, if you live up to those intentions, if you put those in place, what will your day in the future look like? So that's a good opportunity to kind of take a look at that as well. So lots of different ideas for how to kind of set this up. You're welcome to share in the chat if you're doing something a little bit different, kind of what you're thinking. If you want to focus it on a day in the life with your pet, maybe you want to do this from your pet's point of view, right? So if you have a cat, what will a year from now, what will your cat be saying that you're doing? What will your cat be saying, how you're feeling? Those kinds of things, right? So a cat, dog, lizard, bird, whatever kind of pet you have, right? Sometimes it's fun to kind of imagine how they would be thinking. So again, you've got this here on page 15, but you're also welcome to use post-it notes or scratch pad, whatever works for you. So here's these ideas. And I'm just going to, again, play some music. We'll check in the chat, see how folks are doing, and then we'll see where we go from there. All right. Believe it or not, we are coming up toward the end, but I just want to say that I really appreciate how vulnerable folks are being in the chat, sharing with each other, sharing tips for kind of getting over some struggles that some folks have had. I loved, was it Nona Natalie that had the suggestion of we need to put a reminder, make an appointment in your phone for January 26, 2024. To look back at this page and see what that looks like. And she was kind of talking about how she spent some time looking back at past journals and really realizing that things have changed for her. She's had some good breakthroughs and things have been good over the course of the last year. So it is really important, I think, for us to spend some time and we write these things down. We document this piece of time and we think about what we want the next year or the next month or whatever to look like. And then we look back at that, right? And I know someone mentioned that they really appreciated the suggestion to look back at your intentions for the month, right? Flip back through, give yourself some time, set a little alarm in your phone to flip back through your journal, even on a monthly basis, right? As you kind of go through, because it's pretty, it's always amazing to me how much I forget what I've done in the course of a month or 6 months or a year. So these journals are a great source of being able to go back and kind of take a look and see how that goes. So with that said, thank you everyone for sharing. You're welcome to share anything from tonight's social within the Sonder Club. Again, it's whatever you feel comfortable sharing. We don't require you to share it all. I think you may still get a survey, but I know that they're getting ready to put a pause on the survey because they're going to do some revamping for February. And as you probably know, we're kind of doing some revamping with social schedules. You'll see in the month of February, we have added a weekly setup on Saturdays. So that'll be there. We're still kind of changing some things around. So if you have any suggestions or anything that you want them to know and you don't get a survey, you can always send an email to hello@silkandsonder.com and let them know if you want more journal prompt socials, if you want the cooking social to come back, if you want more coloring socials, et cetera, right? So kind of letting folks know. We also have the QR code here for the Refer a Friend program. You get $10 and your friend gets $10 if they join. Hopefully everyone is in Sonder Club, the Sonder Club app. There was a fun, I haven't listened to the daily ritual for today, but everyone was posting their superhero names. So I think that was part of the daily ritual. So I feel like I need to go in there and see what that was all about so I can post that there. And remember, I see people say things like, oh, I'm behind in the daily rituals. You're not behind, right? You're not. You're right where you need to be. You don't have to go back and make them up. They're always there for you to do whenever you feel like. So don't get that behind feeling. And then of course, there's the ever popular YouTube link for our recordings. Again, like I said, it's got me, it's got the slides. Sometimes the music is there, sometimes it's not, but it doesn't have the chat, but you can always go there to kind of take a look. If you want to revisit anything, give us a few days to get that put up. All right. So, and as promised, here's the playlist. If you want to take a snapshot of that, I can get a copy of the link and pop that in the chat as well for Spotify, if you want to go and find that. And so thank you all for being here, getting some more things written down in your journal. Jennifer and I really appreciate seeing you here tonight and seeing you here in the chat. And hopefully we will see you again soon. All right. Take care and have a fantastic rest of your week. Good weekend. And just so you know, when you come in here and you do all this work in your journal, you make it look easy for everyone else, right? So thanks for being here, and we will see you again soon.
We make it look easy.